Hi everyone, it's Maya here. Today I'm going to be playing Reflection by Tool. I am really, really excited to play this because this is the first time I'm going to be using traditional Indian Carnatic music slides in a metal song. I think you all will really like it because it's really different and I have never tried this before. As usual, I have a lot more to say and I'll say it at the end. Now, enjoy this mesmerizing song.
Thank you.
Now that was a really, really amazing song. Did you all enjoy it too? Now you see why I said I'm going to be using my super fast sliding Carnatic techniques in a metal song for the first time ever. So what I did is, I learned that I've been learning Carnatic music for a while now, and I learned how to do those slides. So now all I did was, I was thinking, I know Carnatic music and I know metal and tool, of course. So why don't I merge them both together? So that's exactly what I did. I traced down the notes that the violin plays by hearing it, and then I reproduced that in guitar using the Carnatic sliding technique, and it was really awesome. I was so happy when I finished it, because this is really different for me, and I really enjoy how these two can merge together so well. That's something I also like about Tool. They use so many different things and put it all together in one massive, beautiful song. And that just makes me fall in love with Tool even more. Now, here are some other things I also like about Tool. First, let's start with Maynard James Keenan. The lyrics he sings in this song is just so beautiful. I looked it up and read it myself, and I just love what he sings. It's so emotional. The singing itself can take you through a journey, not mentioning the whole song and everything else. And when he sings, he has some effect on it. When he sings up and down, and as with that effect, as well as the lyrics he sings, it's like, oh, it's just so beautiful. And that plays a huge part in Reflexive. Next, Danny Carey and the bass. Wow, Danny Carey is like the octopus. He hits everything everywhere. I've seen videos of him do that. It's just crazy on how he does it, and I really love it. But how he did it in this song, it felt like he limited himself a bit and stuck to some things. He still did a Danny style, not super easy, but still not crazy as he would have done. But I'm saying that completely suits the song, because everything else going on a different track and the drums fully hitting something else will not suit at all. But this, even though he stuck to something a little bit simple, works, and I really love how he does that, and especially in songs like this where he needs to keep it low for some time because the other things are also not going so crazy, as well as the bass. It feels like he also limited himself a little bit and didn't do too much variations in everything, just sticking to the same beat. But still, Justin Chancellor did a good job in it and still did a few variations here and there that I do really like. And same, it suits the song well and doesn't go too much into everything else. Next, Adam Jones. He is octopus number two. He uses everything when he plays. He uses his hands for playing, his feet for footswitch, and even his mouth like in Jambi. I really love how he does everything. And in this song, I read somewhere that he actually controls the synth within his foot while he plays the guitar at the same time. I was so shocked when I heard that. How can he do that? How can he control everything at the same time? He is the most talented person I have ever seen. And in this, he does those hammer ones in the middle, and then he just mutes them in the middle, like does a little dud. It's so simple and yet so beautiful. I don't know how anyone else has thought of that. And this, I really love things about this, because Adam Jones does things so simple and so beautiful, and it feels like he does what's needed. He never does too much and he never does too less. And especially in this song, I think he did everything perfectly. The way he arranged everything is very perfect, and I love how he plays the whole thing throughout the song. It gets me very emotional hearing Tool songs like this, and it just feels like I go to a different zone. I'm in a different place when I listen to Tool songs. I'm like, I go away from my normal everyday life and go into a full different mesmerizing zone. And those are the things I really love about Tool. So I had a really amazing time learning this song and showing it to you guys, especially my new Carnatic technique in the violin. I was really excited to show this to you all. So I hope you went on the journey with me, and I hope you also liked it. So I'll see you in the next one.